yeah, brother. You're on the Please Me Fall on YouTube channel.
Afternoon, do it for Dailers today. We're going to be testing the launch control on Leroy, but it's going to rain, so we have some shuffling to do. We got the t-shirt factory over here and then the C7. So we're going to move some cars around and then we're going to get the car out. We got to hook up the two-step. We did pre-wire it a little bit, but there's some stuff left to do, and then I got to hook up the boost by gear. It's going to be fun. I'm just excited to hear it go pop, pop, bang, bang. So this Lingenfelter launch and timing controller is hooked up, and I pretty much think it's completely hooked up correctly. When I push the clutch in, the activate light comes on like it said. It's hooked up into the plug wire harness, so I guess we just gotta give it a go and see what it does. It's set for 4,000 RPM. Haven't really adjusted it off the factory settings, but we can move into that later when we wanna raise and lower the boost.
Yeah, it sounded pretty rowdy.
That sounded super rowdy. Well, I'm not gonna mess with it then. If it made 5 pounds,
thanks for looking at us.
We're pretty good. Yeah, guys, see ya.
No problem. Take it easy.
If it made 5 pounds that easily,
you don't want to run just a secondary test. I mean, you've only done this once.
I know. We should probably give my neighbors a minute. Yeah. the neighbor's gonna love that. That was loud.
That was really loud. I mean, we're not over here revving our VTEC, so.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Dude, that is sick. Can't wait to do that at night.
Oh, the fireballs are gonna be unreal.
I hate Florida. Look at this. We thought we were gonna have some light rain. We didn't even hook these up. Oh no, Florida had different plans for us.
Maybe we should just go low and work like this in the rafters.
This is ridiculous.
Oh, we got a link. We test the two-step in the rain. I think it's the only logical thing to do.
People just think it's lightning or something. Thunder. Oh, geez.
Ready?
Yeah, I'm standing over here. This is where I don't get wet.
So that was 4,500 RPM. Sounded a little bit different, but it's making like 6 pounds of boost. That's plenty for what we're gonna need to leave on. Probably drop it back down to 4,000. That seemed to be good, and we'll keep it there until we can get to the track and test it. But the launch control definitely freaking works, and it sounds incredible. Now what we're gonna do is hook up the TurboSmart eBoost 2, my boost controller. It has boost by gear, so we gotta hook up a couple buttons to that. All we have to do is put a power to the switch for the clutch, so when the clutch goes in, it switches up a boost group, and then you have to have a reset switch up here, so it should be pretty easy, and it's going to be worth it to have boost by gear, because going up in power as we go down the track will be helpful to get a freaking gnarly time. We can't just leave on all the power and blow the tires off, so we're going to work on that now and hopefully finish it up. All right, guys, so check this out. We went to Faster Proms where it's a little bit more dry, and we got this boost by gear deal all set up, and it is sick. So check this out. So it's in setting one right now. This would be like wastegate pressure. And then when I push down the clutch, here, I'm going to go back to this, but I'm pushing the clutch in, boom, switches up, boom, switches up. And that's switching up into my different boost groups. So I've got my boost group set up to ramp into higher boost as I go up a gear. And so we figured out how to leave in setting one. So I'll probably leave on like wastegate pressure, and then the next shift, it'll go up and boost. Next shift, go up and boost. And it'll allow us to bring in the power up on the top end where you can get a little bit more traction. Hopefully this works. We have to just test it, but that is sick. That eBoost 2 is so easy to use. TurboSmart hooked us up with that and freaking love it. It's worked so well this far. And then also we changed the oil. Texas Speed sent us a bunch of brake-in oil, as well as we now have the regular oil you're supposed to run the engine on. They provide what they like to use, and it works best that way. Pretty much at this point, guys, we're just going to throw the car in the trailer and head to Omaha. We found a drag strip that we're going to hit tomorrow night and do some low-key testing, and hopefully Leroy can perform it. The race is only a couple days out now, and we have freaking 24 hours of driving to do just to get to Omaha. Plus, we're going to stop and hit the track, so Cooper and I have a lot of stuff to do. The trailer's pretty much packed up. Still, we got a lot to do. We got to bring shirts, merch. It's going to be a fun weekend, but man, this project and everything leading up to it has been so much work, but everybody who's been involved in this project has done an incredible job. So all we got to do now is get to driving. Thanks for watching. Do it for Dale. We'll see you later.
Well, dang. Hope you enjoyed your time on the Cletus McFarland YouTube channel. Check out some of our t-shirts. We've got the Do It For Dale t-shirt, the Do It For America t-shirt, and of course the Twin Terpsies t-shirt, all of which can be found in the link in the description below. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe and check out this video that we posted earlier this week.